statistics and probability. Here we are going to see about the standard deviation, how we are going to find the standard deviation for the grouped and ungrouped data. In our 10th standard syllabus, the major portion here we are going to study about the how to find the standard deviation. For in standard deviation, here we are going to find the data by the grouped data and the ungrouped data. One is ungrouped data, and then another one is here grouped data. In grouped data, we have discrete and continuous form. In grouped data, we have discrete and continuous in grouped data we have discrete and continuous. Let's see later what is that. Here we have four different methods to find out that grouped and ungrouped data. Here we have four different methods to find the standard deviation. One is direct method, and then second one is the mean method, and the third one is the assumed mean method. And then fourth one is the step deviation method. For to find the standard deviation of ungrouped data. Next we have that in grouped data we have only three method except the direct method. We have first one is the mean method, and then second one is assumed mean method, and then third one is a step deviation method. And just we recall what we have seen in the last video. So in the last video we have said that it is a variance is equal to sigma square is equal to summation xi minus x bar whole square divided by n, and then standard deviation is nothing but the square, the positive square root of variance is the standard deviation. Here we can use the standard deviation as SD also, or sigma is equal to root of summation. We have taken the positive value only, root of summation xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. Now we see how to calculate the standard deviation for ungrouped data. For first one, direct method. One is direct method. How to find the standard deviation? Here the standard deviation, if we take it as shortly, SD. SD means standard deviation. We use the symbol as sigma is equal to root of summation xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. Now simple solving this term, it is in the form of a minus b whole square. Just apply the formula a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. In this formula I am going to apply here. So the root of summation xi square, that is a square, minus 2 into xi x bar plus x bar square divided by n. Simply we have taken that a minus b whole square formula, right? Now the summation is, we have to split it into each and every term, and then the denominator n is belongs to whole the term. We have to separate the terms like this, root of, see, summation. Summation, if you take inside, means each and every term should be multiplied by summation. Summation xi square, here with the n is common to all the terms, so we split it to each and every term, minus 2, x bar will be take it out, and then for xi we have that summation, summation xi divided by n, plus here x bar square will be take it out, summation 1 divided by n. Summation 1 means here it represents the number of observation. Here number of observation is n. So general term, we are finding the general term. So the number of observation is n. So the next step, see, root of summation xi square divided by n minus 2x bar. See, summation xi divided by n is nothing but we know the formula, that is mean formula. So this is the mean formula. X bar is equal to summation xi divided by n. So in the place of summation xi divided by n, I replace into x bar. Right, in the place of summation xi divided by n is nothing but x bar, that is mean. So I replaced here. Then we have x bar square. Summation 1 is nothing but up to the nth term. Here sum of all the observations, sum of all the observation is nothing but n divided by n. So here n will be cancelled. See, here we have summation xi square divided by n minus here 2 x bar into x bar means 2 x bar square plus x bar square, right? Next we have the sigma is equal to summation xi square divided by n minus 2 into x bar square plus x bar square. See, x bar square, 2 x bar square plus 1 by x bar square will be subtract. We get that root of summation xi square divided by n minus x bar square. X bar is nothing but we know that summation xi divided by n. X bar is nothing but summation xi divided by n. Therefore, the standard deviation sigma is equal to root of summation xi square divided by n minus summation xi divided by n. Here we have whole square. See, sigma is equal to, that is standard deviation. Standard deviation. Sigma is equal to root of summation xi square divided by n minus summation xi divided by n whole square is the formula for direct method. Let's see one example sum for the direct method to find the standard deviation. Here 10, let me take it as 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50 as our own values, right? Let me split it into, to find the standard deviation, sigma is equal to, we know the formula, root of summation xi square divided by n minus summation xi divided by n whole square is the formula, right? So summation of xi is 90, 120, 150. So this term is equal to 150. When we square this term, we get 100, 400, 900, 1600, 2500. Then sum of the value is, so summation of xi square is nothing but 5500. Now we want to find out the how many terms here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So n is equal to 5. So we are finding the standard deviation, root of summation xi square is nothing but 5500 divided by n, 5 minus summation xi is nothing but 150 divided by 5 whole square. Now cancel this. 11, sir, this term is equal to root of 1100 minus, if you cancel this, 30 square is nothing but 900. When you subtract this, we get 200 can be written in the form of 2 into 100, right? 200 can be written in the form of 2 into 100. 100 is a perfect square number, so 10 into root 2. Root 2 is value is 1.414. If you multiply by 10, we get 14.14. For by using the direct method, we can find out at that 14.14. So if it is a smaller number, smaller data, means it is very easy to find out that by using the direct method. If it is compared to the larger data, that is 10 to 150 or 10 to 200, like this, it is very hard to find the square values and we made some mistakes, right? So here we have another method to find out the alterly. We have the another method. So next method is the mean method. See, the mean method, the standard deviation is sigma is equal to root of summation xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. Here in the place of xi minus x bar, the deviation only differs where di is equal to, the deviation di is equal to xi minus x bar. You are going to replace this xi minus x bar in the place di. So the standard deviation sigma is equal to root of summation di square divided by n, right? Here let me check it, the same formula here, in the place of xi we are going to substitute that for mean method di square. Here also we have di, but here the di, summation of di is always 0 in mean method. Let's check it. Let me take the same observation 10, 20, 30, 40 for the same sum. Already we have found it for the standard deviation in direct method. We get the answer. Now we have that the same with the deviation di is equal to xi minus x bar. Only differs in this term only. So xi minus x bar is d. Here x bar is find out, that is mean is 30. So in this place 10 minus 30. Xi is nothing but 10 minus 30 is equal to minus 20. 20 minus 30 is equal to minus 10. 30 minus 30 is equal to 0. Then 40 minus 30 is equal to 10. Then 50 minus 30 is equal to 20. When we add this, see here we have both a negative symbol, minus 30, here we have plus 30, both are cancelled. That is, summation of di is always 0 in mean method. Now we want to find out di square. When you square this, we get positive value only. 20 square is 400, 10 square is 100, only we get positive value, right? When we square 0, and then 10 square is 100, 20 square is 400. So summation di square is equal to, when we add this term, 0, 0, 10, that is 1000. Now we want to find the standard deviation. Sigma is equal to root of, we know the formula, summation di square divided by n is the standard deviation's formula, summation di square divided by n. So in this place we are going to apply this. Summation di square is nothing but 1000, n is nothing but 5. So we get root 200. Root 200 is nothing but 2 into 100, right? So 2 into 100 means 100 is a perfect square number. 10 root 2. Root 2 value is 1.414. So we get 14.14. We get the same answer where we are using the mean method or direct method, right? So for the mean method, the standard deviation sigma is equal to, this is the formula. So only differs in the deviation. The deviation is di is equal to xi minus x bar. Next we see the assumed mean method. Next assumed mean method, standard deviation is a standard form, summation xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. Here the deviation is differs d